Hey guys, I'm going to cover the calcium phosphorus ratio today. So we ran, my wife and I, in Wellness Unleashed with Dr. Mark and Maureen, we did one of our osteoporosis bone buster shakes. And so that's on our YouTube page, Facebook page. Then we also did the different types of calcium, but then I started getting questions in the office about different things. And one of them is, what are you talking about when you mention phosphorus? So the calcium phosphorus ratio is what I'm going to cover today. So calcium and phosphorus should be 10 to 4 ratio in the body. I like to run phosphorus on blood work because we see, you know, most people don't do that. Unless you're doing nutrition, there's no need to do it because you have to fix this nutritionally. So phosphorus, by the way, is an accelerator. I just got done with a 40-mile bike ride. I just hammered it out, and phosphorus would certainly have helped me. Now, you can't take phosphorus, if you got a fast heart rate, it is an accelerator, and so we see that on our heart sound recorder. When we see that imbalance, we correct that imbalance. So, but calcium phosphorus should be 10 to 4. Here's the thing: if we run the blood work and we see 3 parts calcium to 10, you just figure out the ratio. It's 10 to 4, 2.5 to 1. 3 parts phosphorus to calcium. That's going to be not enough phosphorus in the city and in the system. And then calcium is going to precipitate out of the fluid and cause too much calcium. It'll cause a few things. Like number one, it could cause kidney stones. In the body, it can cause tartar on your teeth. You know, people who keep having tartar problems, they go get cleaned, you know, constantly. I see a few of those. You know, phosphorus is a great thing to stop that. Arthritis, so too much calcium, not enough phosphorus. So bone spurs and give you arthritis, spinal arthritis, arthritis of the joints. So, and the other thing, the body could just go ahead and create cataracts because of it. Because phosphorus is going to deplete calcium. It's got to be, not depleted totally, but they work against each other. So if you have 4 parts phosphorus and 9 parts calcium, not enough calcium, or calcium deficiency, it's going to create things like cavities, not enough calcium, so not enough, it'll affect the bones, not enough bone. Osteoporosis, that's a disease, it's not enough bone. So it could create rheumatoid arthritis, it could play a part in rheumatoid arthritis. And so in those cases, we need to deal with that. We need to balance this first so this isn't going on. And then we need to give the nutrients to help bone. So that's what we do in these cases here. So that's how the calcium phosphorus ratio works. I always take it on initial blood work. Sometimes it's fine and we don't have to deal with it. Sometimes it's not. But on my nutrition patients that are, you know, continue, we always want to keep track of that. We want to be preventative. We don't want to have any of these or other things that it caused going on. So that's how that ratio works. And it's very important that we keep that right in a nutritional standpoint. Okay guys, thanks a lot. Until next time, reclaim your health, reclaim your life.